1. Fill in the blanks with suitable answers. 1. Economic development is a process in which the real national income of a country increases. 2. The value of goods and service produced in year is called as national. 3. In an underdeveloped country, basically the per capita is lower income. 4. Human development indicates expansion of human welfare. 1. Fill in the blanks with suitable answers. 6. India ranked 135 in HDI in 2014. 7. Sex ratio was 0.563 in India in 2011. 2. Answer the following questions in 5 to 6 sentences each. 1. Define development and explain the process of development. Answer: the word development often refers to the progress in a particular field or a segment of people, like rural development, social development, educational development, women and children development, etc. An economy continuously attempts to progress, providing for more and more quantities of goods and services to the people and improving their well-being. This process of enhancing society's capacity to satisfy its needs on a larger scale is referred to as development. Answer: the word development often refers to the progress in a particular field or a segment of people, like rural development, social development, educational development, women and children development, etc. An economy continuously attempts to progress, providing for more and more quantities of goods and services to the people and improving their well-being. This process of enhancing society's capacity to satisfy its needs on a larger scale is referred to as development. Answer: the word development often refers to the progress in a particular field or a segment of people, like rural development, social development, educational development, women and children development, etc. An economy continuously attempts to progress, providing for more and more quantities of goods and services to the people and improving their well-being. This process of enhancing society's capacity to satisfy its needs on a larger scale is referred to as development. 2. What do you mean by underdevelopment? What are its causes? Answer: the word underdevelopment denotes a backward and stagnant situation where levels of living of people are low due to lower level of per capita income and lower productivity levels, apart from high population growth. 3. What is HDI? How is it calculated? Answer: HDI refers to Human Development Index. The United Nations Development Programme has used the idea to construct HDI. The core capabilities of a country's population are defined, measured and combined to derive the composite HDI. While health is measured in terms of life expectancy, education is measured in terms of literacy attainment, and purchasing power through per capita income. The average of these three indicators is the HDI. Answer: HDI refers to Human Development Index. The United Nations Development Programme has used the idea to construct HDI. The core capabilities of a country's population are defined, measured and combined to derive the composite HDI. While health is measured in terms of life expectancy, education is measured in terms of literacy attainment, and purchasing power through per capita income. The average of these three indicators is the HDI. Answer: HDI refers to Human Development Index. The United Nations Development Programme has used the idea to construct HDI. The core capabilities of a country's population are defined, measured and combined to derive the composite HDI. While health is measured in terms of life expectancy, education is measured in terms of literacy attainment, and purchasing power through per capita income. The average of these three indicators is the HDI. Answer: HDI refers to Human Development Index. The United Nations Development Programme has used the idea to construct HDI. The core capabilities of a country's population are defined, measured and combined to derive the composite HDI. While health is measured in terms of life expectancy, education is measured in terms of literacy attainment, and purchasing power through per capita income. The average of these three indicators is the HDI. Answer: HDI refers to Human Development Index. The United Nations Development Programme has used the idea to construct HDI. The core capabilities of a country's population are defined, measured and combined to derive the composite HDI. While health is measured in terms of life expectancy, education is measured in terms of literacy attainment, and purchasing power through per capita income. The average of these three indicators is the HDI. 4. Examine the causes for low HDI of India. Answer: some of the causes for low HDI of India are gender discrimination. It is seen in various dimensions of Indian society, economy and polity, and sex ratio. Women, who form half of the population, are deprived of social, economic, educational and political equality. Answer: some of the causes for low HDI of India are gender discrimination. It is seen in various dimensions of Indian society, economy and polity, and sex ratio. Women, who form half of the population, are deprived of social, economic, educational and political equality. Development. Women mainly work in unorganized activities at lower wages than men. Many household women eat last after the head and children have had food. This makes her malnourished and susceptible to many illnesses. India has very high rate of maternal, infant death rates. Representation of women in political bodies is limited to the reserved strength. 5. How to achieve gender equality. Answer: measures taken to achieve gender equality are _ self-help groups SHG are being formed in all the villages and cities. A SHG is a group of women who come together to share their meager resources, obtain external support, undertake business jointly and earn income. A SHG is a group of women who come together to share their meager resources, obtain external support, undertake business jointly and earn income. In recent years, many steps are initiated for the empowerment of women. Many laws have been enacted to curb violence against women at home and at workplaces, to guarantee equal wages, providing reservation of seats in elected bodies, etc.